And what about combining filtering with vector search, like with looking for the nearest or approximately nearest neighbor? What are the use cases for those type of queries? And once you have such a query, do you take advantage of indexes, or you do a query and then you need to do a brute force? Maybe starting from just, you know, use cases, when would you ask vector database to filter?
When it comes to metadata, right, oftentimes what happens is you'll have a vector field, a row, quote unquote, in your vector database. I really don't like to use that term, but or an entity in your vector database. You have a vector, and that vector is associated with maybe, you know, half a dozen or a dozen pieces of metadata. And I'll give you an example of what that might look like. If I'm doing product recommendation, okay, not product recommendation. Let me just pull back there. If I'm doing retrieval augmented generation, right, my vector corresponds to a document, right? It corresponds to a string of text, you know, corresponds to the embedding generated through a string of text. You know, it could be a document chunk, it could be a full document. We don't know, right? And metadata could be, let's say, the name of the document. It could be the length of the chunk in terms of, let's say, number of tokens. It could be, you know, what are some other, it could be the author of the doc. It could be the user. It could be a, you know, potentially a list of users who have access to that document. Right. So what the metadata allows you to do is it allows you to perform filtered search. So let's say again, I want to find nearest neighbors or nearest documents, but I want to do it only for the larger chunks. I want to do it for this hypothetical application, very hypothetical. I want to do it only for larger documents, or I want to do it for larger document chunks. Then I could filter, you know, I could say, okay, I want to do the vector search, but I only want to return the results where the length of the document is greater than some number of tokens n, right? Or some number of words n. And or some number of characters in, you know, whatever you want. That is filtered search. That is what we like to call in milvus, we like to call that hybrid search. And that is metadata or scalar filtering plus vector search. Now you were talking about, and this is why I had that a bit of that pause there. I was trying to figure out, okay, what's the best place to start from a technical perspective. If I want to implement metadata search, if I want to implement scalar filtering, excuse me, I have to figure out, okay, should I apply a pre-filter or should I apply a post-filter, or should I do this directly with the index? And that's where it starts to become a little bit tricky. Is merging metadata with the individual indexes. Now, if we look at, for example, go back to the example, Piotr, you were talking about k-means of the invert file of IVF. The only, you know, it no longer works very well. And I'll tell you why. It's because I have all of these centroids, right? I have all these centroids, and all of a sudden, if my nearest neighbor vectors, you know, I have a very, very strong filter, and my nearest neighbor vectors, I can no longer get a top 10 using, you know, by probing, let's say 32 centroids or 64 centroids. None of the vectors in those centroids fulfill my metadata criteria. Now, all of a sudden I return you zero results, right? That's a pretty bad user experience.
Distribution of data as well, right?
Yeah. You have to look at the distribution of the data as well. Yeah. And
I mean, when your database is distributed, right? It should also solve part of this problem, because you can then find more, I guess, data.
You could, but typically for IVF, you use a value of nprobe, and your nprobe value is fixed. So I say, okay, I want to search the nearest 64 centroids. I want to search the nearest 128 centroids, and that value is fixed. I'll search only those. And if I have a very strong metadata filter, then all of a sudden it's like, oh, you know, I'm doing this post filtering, and I'm returning you zero results. That's a pretty bad, like that's just not ideal. So, you know, there's a lot of details And again, I won't go into a lot of details. I'm actually not as familiar with a lot of the details of metadata filtering, but one of the strategies for mitigating this is to maintain statistics over each metadata field. Maintain either a small index or maintain statistics over the metadata field. Now, what that gives, what that tells me is this, right? If I have, I have a district, you know, again, going back to the example of, I want to find relevant documents, but only greater than length n. I can maintain a distribution, you know, of values. If my metadata field is an integer field, I can maintain a distribution of those integers. And I can say, okay, if n is a very small number, okay, post-filtering is probably fine. But if n is a very big number, where it's a very strong filter, then maybe what I want to do is I want to do some sort of pre-filter first and then brute force the rest of it. Right. So I'll do a pre-filter, and instead of going over the index, I'll brute force the rest of it. And what that gives me is, you know, pre-filtering, a lot of people will say, okay, you'll do a pre-filter. Isn't that really, really inefficient? And my response to them is, it's much more efficient than doing vector search. Because what am I doing with vector search? I'm essentially doing lots and lots of math, tons of math. But if I do a pre-filter, I just need to do a comparison. Right, maybe I do a less than, maybe I do less than, greater than, equal to, right? Just a comparison of a single field.
Do you use Elastic under the hood for it? Or
No, we don't use Elastic under the hood for this. Everything, you know, all metadata filtering in milvus is done just by milvus. It's done with milvus.
We are more lazy at Neptune. we have a similar, like, not a vector search. It's not a use case for us, but... we are experiment tracker, and that scales pretty well. Like, some of the projects have millions of experiments, and each experiment has a set of parameters, metrics. They don't need to be necessarily equal. And we need to support a search, multidimensional search, where you would like to find experiments that are have accuracy greater than that, that where data set was that were trained on this data set, etc. And it was quite a challenging thing to implement based on the traditional SQL database. And we ended up doing a hybrid of SQL database with Elastic. And it works pretty well, and I was curious, you know, how did you solve this part?
Yeah, you know, metadata filtering, there's a lot of tricks inside metadata filtering that even I'm unaware of, and only our performance, our core indexing team is the right team to go to for that kind of stuff.
So do I understand correctly still that you kind of need to very well understand your application to decide kind of. Do you do pre-filtering or post-filtering, right? Because it's not automated for you.
We automate some of that for you. No, we definitely automate some of that for you. We automate all of it for you. And we have the capability to build indexes over metadata fields too. But what I was talking about earlier is just sort of giving a sense as to why metadata search is hard and why, right? Why you would want to build metadata search in the way, you know, why it's harder to do metadata search than most people think is because you have all these different things that you have to think about, all these different things that you need to take care of. And it's not as simple as just saying, hey, you know, I'm going to do a post filter or I'm going to do a pre filter. It's not that simple, right? You have a lot more things that you have to think about and a lot more things you have to take care of. And in some situations, you'll do just a pre filter. In some situations, you'll do just a post filter. And in others, you'll combine the two. You'll do both pre and post filtering. And which sort of strategy you do depends on A, the distribution of your data, not your vector data, but of your metadata, of your scalar fields. But also, let's say, how much data that you have, right? If you don't have that much data, it's better just to apply a pre-filter pretty much all the time.
I think it balances those two strategies, pre-filtering and post-filtering. I see a proper kind of a property, statistical property. Of course, it can be I'm saying that approximately it should work. I see edge cases as well. But like, what's wrong with pre-filtering? The wrong thing about pre-filtering is that potentially you will need to do a brute force over a lot of vectors, right? So then it is maybe better to go to post-filtering. But if the amount, like the filters you applied, did like still the subset is pretty big, quite likely post-filtering is not so terrible because those points are not so unique. Of course, there are edge cases, but I think that in real life cases, yeah, like it helps. This dependency helps. So for some use cases, it's better to use this. For others, it's better to use the second option.
Absolutely. Yeah, I agree with you there. I agree with you. And again, it's also dependent on the type of vector index that you use as well. So if you use a graph-based vector index, it's easier to do combined filtering. I'm not going to call it pre-filtering. I'm not going to call it post-filtering, but it's easier to traverse the graph and to continue traversing the graph until I, let's say, get a set of fields that are there for my metadata fields. Again, or I get a set of vectors that fulfill my metadata. And again, it's not that simple. If I'm doing some very, very, very strong filtering, it's probably better just to apply a pre-filter, get an index, get a reverse index to the vectors and do a brute force over those vectors, right? So it's tricky. It's tricky. And there's no one great way to do it. But I just want to give an idea as to why it's hard. But you're right, Piotr. It's in different... Under different circumstances, you might want to do a pre-filter and you might want to do a post-filter. And it really depends on what you're trying to build.